Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.
This is a special day for me, man. God just keep dropping gems on me, man. And to be honest with you, man, you never know what God is doing, man. He always got something to where he got something held back to where he can show you, okay, I did this for you. You didn't even see it. Mm-hmm. Man, so I met this guy, man, seven years ago or so, man. He came to my shop. He was like, man, I'm doing a cypher, man. I'm putting my artists in, man. We're trying to get it going, man. And he was so passionate about it. And I didn't know, really, and it's sad, I didn't even know his name. I just wanted to work with him. I didn't care. Say, man, we got that boy Prophecy in the building.
Hey, what's up, B? How you doing, man?
Man, this dude here, man, he usually don't get in front of the camera. You notice I've been getting people in front of the camera that usually mm-hmm. don't?
But yeah. Most videographers or photographers don't ever get in front of the camera.
They love being behind the scenes.
Behind the scenes.
But creative work, that's what, and this guy, man. So what drives you to work like this, man?
What drives me to work?
Yeah, like...
Because I've seen my father work.
Wow.
You know what I mean? Ever since I was young, like, to be honest, that's what drives me because I see them, like, they used to wake us up at 5 in the morning to go to work, yeah. Because they had to be at work at 6, and then they had to drive me to somebody's house, and then they had to drive me to school, and then they had to drive back home, and I had to wait till, like, 7, 8 o'clock till my parents got home, and then they were tired.
Yeah.
And then do that shit again all over again.
All over again.
Yeah.
Man,
I told them I don't want my kids living like that.
Wow, you gonna change the game?
But it builds something.
It builds character, right?
You know, a lot of times I hear my husband because he went through things like
that
with his dad, and you know we try to not do that for our kids, but it made you into the man you are. You wouldn't want to change that for nothing. And sometimes we tend to not want to. We want to give our kids an easier life, but sometimes that can make them soft.
Definitely not, of course. And I make my kids work because, you know, I want them to see me work like that. What motivated my dad worked all the time. So he still works all the time. Even when he's not working, he's doing something. He's moving around.
Yeah,
he just doesn't sit down. He's just, I was like, if people think that I'm the hardest worker, but I looked at my dad and he doesn't stop. I'm like, dog, like, I don't ever feel like I could outwork him.
Yeah. Have you ever told him that, though?
Yeah, I told him that.
Okay. My dad.
Just recently, over the past, like, 2-3 years, I've started to realize, you know, I've become a father. And I started telling my dad, I was like, dog, like, you know, you inspire me. Like,
it's
something else. Yeah.
That is so crazy. No,
same thing to me.
I did the same thing to my mom. Whenever I got married and I had kids and I was like, oh, my God, how you balance all of this? Mm-hmm. I called her and I was like, Mom, I don't know how you did it. You're a super mom. Because to me, I'm like, until you're put in that position, until you have kids, until you have a mate, you know, you don't realize how much energy it takes to be able to balance time for everybody, you know, and then find time for yourself. So I told her, I was like, no, you did an awesome job.
Yeah, man. So when you first started out, so 7 years ago when you came here, how long had you been doing that before you came here?
Probably like 2 years.
2 years.
Yeah.
And you was did you know where you was going with it, or you just kind of was just
doing what
you love?
Yeah, I love music. I love putting artists on. You know, like at the time there wasn't a lot of videographers, and especially nobody was trying to put any artists on. You know what I mean? So I took it upon myself and I started creating these ciphers.
That was around the time where it was a big budget for a video. That was coming out of that time, you know, like when the majors would do a video and you had already mastered the concept of understanding DSRs back then.
Yeah, I was all right, man. Like I said, I wasn't looking back at my videos now. I wasn't the best.
Yeah.
But I was doing something for the people around me, for the artists around me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that's kind of what motivated me. At the same time, they were, you know what I mean? Like those I was doing for free, but, you know, they were paying me to do videos. It was like maybe $200-$300.
Yeah.
At the time, it wasn't a lot.
No.
But, you know, it got to a point where I was doing so many of them, I was getting paid more than, you know, what I was getting paid out of the job.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. That's crazy, man. I sat back and I just, like I said, when I seen it was you, I started looking through all of it. And I seen, like, wasn't it Kevin Gates, Mo3, different people. Who would you say the biggest artist you work with in your eyes? Because that would be your opinion, really.
The biggest artist I worked with? I mean, to be honest, I feel like Mo3 was bigger than everybody. Well, he was going to be bigger than everybody, yeah.
You think he had it?
He had it in him to be, you know, like top five in the nation.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Not just here in Dallas, but, you know, he was just so diverse, you know what I mean? That's what I felt, and I felt it from day one.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.